The Inspector General of Police, Abbas Biakagaba, has appointed Assistant Commissioner of Police, Rosoke Kituma, as the new police spokesperson. He replaces Senior Superintendent of Police, Fred Enanga, who has now taken up a new appointment as the Deputy Director, Interpol. Fred Enanga was first appointed as the police spokesperson in 2014, replacing Judith Nabakoba, the current Minister of Lands, Housing and Urban Development. He was later succeeded by Assistant Inspector General of Police Andrew Felix Kawesi in 2016. After the assassination of Kawesi, AIGP Hassan Kasinje, then the Director of Interpol, was named the police spokesperson, who was eventually replaced by Emilian Kaima by the IGP Kale Kaihura. Enanga returned to the position in 2019 after being reappointed by John Martins Okoth Ochola, who recently retired as IGP. Several lucky winners yesterday walked away with prizes during the climax of the Bride and Groom Expo 2024 edition. The overall winner walked away with a wedding ring from Signature Jewelry. The first runners-up won 50 bottles of wine from Fragolino Wine. The most exciting was Nebasa, who won a brand new gown from Penny Bold Bridal Collections. It was revealed that Nebasa is in final preparations for their wedding and was due to pay for a gown early this week. According to the Chief Executive Officer of Penny Bold Bridal Collections, Penny Kageye, they're going to continue giving back to the community through an attractive discount.
I'm the CEO of the Looks Bespoke in Zambia. Well, it has been a wonderful journey at the Bride and Groom Expo, the 15th edition. I would firstly like to congratulate the team of Bride and Groom Expo for completing 15 years of this. You know, it's not an easy task.
Another winner was Steven Otima, who won two pairs of suits courtesy of the Looks Bespoke. While handing over the suits, the CEO did congratulate the Bride and Groom Expo for this year's edition.
Elajaga kwebazanyo abantu bafebona abafisiza ya kadena baja wano abazo kumolesa guno njagala bebaza singate mwaze moleso tugwandige wadegwa kabinga yugubadde kakosaka kisaka no okwebaza aba sponsors bafebona abatu kwatideko okulaba nti guno moleso gubagwa manyi yugubadde.
Vision Group CEO Don Wanyama appreciated the partners, exhibitors and sponsors of the Bride and Groom Expo 2024. The Bride and Groom Expo 2024 edition started on June 28th and climaxed on June 30th at Logogo Umasho Multipurpose Hall. A section of residents in both Buteva and Sukuda sub-counties in Busia district have decried harassment and pollution by the management of Wagagai Gold Mining Refinery. In the meeting held on Sunday afternoon between persons affected by the project, John Mulimba, the State Minister of Foreign Affairs, and the management of Wagagai Gold Mine Refinery at Mawero Primary School, locals accused the refinery managers of contaminating water sources, noise pollution, damaged the residential houses due to quarrying activities, as well as harassing some of the workers they recruited within the community. Emma Eduki Egesa, the LC3 chairman of Buteva Sub-County, says that they have on several occasions talked to the management of Wagagai Gold Refinery on issues affecting the community, but they paid deaf ears.
They are going to die with these Chinese. They will not come and interfere and also abuse us in our own land unless we hear each other. Yeah, when I'm crying, hear for me. And when you're also crying, I should also understand you. But not to take him as a stranger in our own soil. Never.
The State Minister of Foreign Affairs, who also doubles as the Member of Parliament for Samia Bugwe North, John Mulimba, said Wagagai Company must foster good relations with the community.
The 30 of the Mining and Minerals Act is very emphatic on issues of employment and compensation. Yes, when we arrived here, we had issues of claims of people who were injured, some of them who got maimed and have never been compensated. So I referred them to the law and I told them this one is on negotiation. It's an obligation for which they have to carry out, and they have indeed admitted.
Adam Wang, the Wagagai Gold Mining Refinery sales manager, who was in the meeting, admitted some of the accusations and promised to rectify them.
We received these complaints from our company, and because we have a department named HSE, Yeah, they will receive any news from the company, from local workers. Under the government will give them response how to handle the restriction between company and the local staff.
Wagagai Gold Mining Company, still under construction, covers over 200 acres in the four villages of Mawero, Amagoro, Alupe, and Agoriat, all located in Butera sub-county.